Ever since I've made this sweater on by hand, I've been trying to get the same cable on the machine. Now that I've done the Tree of Life with using a looser stitch, I think that is the key to getting this cable done. So I have my needle set up for 5 needles here, and I have from 0 to 5 on the left, and then I have 1 to 6 on the right. Outside of those 5 needles, I have a needle out of work, so this way here I do not have to reform. But if you like the reform in, keep that needle in work, and then you're going to undo it and just reform it up. Now on the pattern there, it had the cables every row, but I like to stagger them. So what you're going to do is you're going to take the left 2 needles off, you're going to take the right 2 needles. That one single needle is going to stay on there, and then you're going to cross them over. And it doesn't really matter if you cross right to left, left to right. You may want to try different ways of doing it. You may want to keep both of them the same. It is a little tight, but having that one needle out of work does help. And then with any cable, I always bring those needles out of work to non-working position. Holding position. If the machine doesn't knit back from that, then just push it back. But these needles have a little chunk taken out just behind the latch there, and that's taken out so that these needles could bend a little bit better or easier for this type of work. So now I'm going to knit 4 rows. And then I'm going to do the same to the right needles. Now, I'm right-handed, so I like to move the right one over first, and I'll keep doing that. That chain cable was pretty much like that. The center is a little different, though, than this. But the good thing is bringing those needles out to holding position. And I'm not sure if you could see, but see over in here and over here, it is tight, and that's why I'm bringing those needles out to hold, so it will knit back, and I won't have a chance of dropping these stitches. So now I'm going to go on the left again, and you see how I'm staggering it. I don't think I'm going to be able to get the right side over here done the same time as I'm doing this one with it pulling the needles as it does. But I do have my tension dial on 8. I normally would keep it on tension dial 6 or 7 for this yarn. But having a looser stitch is going to give me that capability of doing this cable. So let me do a few more of these, and then I'll take it off the machine and show you the front of this. Well, it's not exactly the same. What I would have to do is that center stitch I would have to reform so that it would look like this chain stitch. And then this is a purl bump there, so I'm going to have to try that next time. Now before I transfer these stitches, I need to reform this center stitch. And so I didn't have to take a lot of time with that. You got to get below or behind that crossover from before. And if the stitches do not come undone, I take my latch transfer tool to undo them. I was trying not to get caught up on the other stitches. What I could do is just put my prong in there. There we go. That's going to go below. So now I could pull that back up again, reform the stitches in the center. And actually, on that blue sweater, I had 6 stitches in between the cables. So you don't have to have it this close, really. I'm just showing that if you want to have it this close, how it's going to be better to stagger the transfers. So that the stitches will knit pretty good. Now see, it's really tight, that's hard. And then the other thing is, see, I'm bringing the left stitch from here out to holding position. So if I was to transfer over here, I wouldn't really be able to, and actually I wouldn't be able to pull these 2 stitches over there. So if I did have the 6 stitches in the middle, but I would still have the 1 needle out of work outside of the cables, then I could probably mimic that same pattern as I did in the hand knit. So knit 4 rows. Now I got to go back over here, and what would be easier if I just had the claw weights on the ends. The Singer machines, the metal beds at least, you really only need the claw weights on the ends there. So I could try to find, let's see, that's the center stitch there, so I got to pull that crossway out until I find the last stitch that was knitted. Maybe what I should do is after row 1 is go ahead and just reform that last stitch. Okay, that's better without the weight on there. So after I do the transfers, I can knit 1 row, find that center stitch, reform it, and then knit 3 more rows to make up for that cable. So this should come out as I have on that blue sweater. So if I knit 1 row, I find that center stitch, I can go down 1 row, undo it. Well, it doesn't want to undo it, but I could use my, although no, I didn't have that in the hook. So I'm probably going to lose this stitch, but good thing this is just a sample. So I would just be careful. I'm going to continue doing it as I did before. On the 8th row of each cable, I would just go down inside that center there, find that center stitch, get it, reform it up. Doing that 1 row is not going to work as I thought it would, because that stitch is really tiny. Of course, having a double bed and working this with a ribber, it would be a little bit easier, I would think. But to get my ribber out, I have to dig through a whole bunch of other boxes. Yeah, I can't even get that last stitch. Let me see if I can get it with the hook. And I'm only grabbing threads. Well, I'm just gonna, because this is a sample, I'm just going to let that go, but I'm sure you get what I'm trying to show here. So there it is. Yes, put in that center stitch to purl on the front here. It's knit on the back side. Does make that look more like my hand knit sweater that I made before.